Ciao comrades! For a while I wanted to install Windows on my Steam Deck. Today is the day when I'm finally doing it. Then I got here this 2TB SSD full of AAA and retro games that I wanna try out. Am I gonna be successful? Let's find out! I was always a bit hesitant about installing Windows on the Deck. Luckily there isn't much that can go wrong, especially with the external installation on the microSD card. And that's what I was doing, installing Windows on the SD card. It was way easier and quicker as I initially anticipated. I've just downloaded the Windows ISO, flashed it with Rufus on the SD card, similarly like you would flash JellOS for your retro handheld. Then I've downloaded a bunch of Windows drivers for Steam Deck's Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, graphics card, etc. And that was basically it. I inserted microSD, I held down power and volume down button to get to the boot manager, I've chosen boot from microSD, I've completed the initial Windows setup, and the final step was installing the Windows drivers. And I was all set, ready for the adventure. As I said, process is fairly straightforward with a minimal risk, because if anything goes wrong, you just take out SD card and it will boot into SteamOS. No damage caused. There are many good tutorials out there. This is not one of them, because we are moving on to the 2TB M.2 SSD, filled up to the brim with video game goodness. It was offered to me for a purpose of review. I was very intrigued by it. I agreed, and here it is. Thanks to the company for sending it over. This was my very first time manipulating with something like this. It says plug and play, so I plugged it in, but it didn't play anything. Steam Deck didn't even recognize it as a drive. I've contacted the company and they said I need a dock, because it needs a lot of power to run. And indeed, when I used dock, Steam Deck recognized it just fine and opened it as a normal drive. Inside, I've seen the folder called Install Me First. I've opened it and run the DirectX repair program that checked and installed everything I was missing. Then there were two options, Playnite and Retrobat. I've clicked on Playnite first, and here, to my surprise, I was greeted with interface that was offering me bunch of latest AAA games to play. God of War, Elden Ring, Spider-Man Remastered, Sekiro Shadow Die Twice, Resident Evil 4, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. I've tried the best ones and it was all running seamless. Well, I had to plug in keyboard and mouse because I was a bit confused with mapping controls to the controller, but other than that it was all top-notch experience. Well, besides the part that these are all basically pirated games that are being officially sold on AliExpress. I've seen them even at the Amazon. Clearly I'm not encouraging you to do anything. You know best what to do, you don't need me for that. Not sure how they can get away with it, but I will tell you one thing. People are always gonna be pirating stuff and buying these. It's same like with retro handhelds and ROMs included. Maybe a bit different cause here are also AAA games. So do as you please, this is just a review. And let's get back to Playnite. Loads of games available in here. They are all playable on the Steam Deck running Windows. As I said, it gotta be plugged into the dock that is plugged into the power supply. This SSD can be also used with a regular PC. I've tried to plug it into my ancient laptop, but it didn't work. I guess because I was plugging it into USB 3.0, and it needs something better than that. Okay, now let's move on, and let's try out Retrobat, the other option besides Playnite. Here, when I launched it, it took me straight into this familiar interface, with bunch of systems to choose from, including Wii U, Switch, PS3, PS2, GameCube, plus the older systems. Retrobat is more focused on the retro gaming and emulation, as the name could imply, and Playnite is for AAA games. Here, only issues I was facing was, again, how the hell do I map the controls properly? It was giving me proper headaches. I figured out how to play with keyboard and mouse, and later even with controller. Some emulators worked fine, even without mapping, but some didn't. It was all new to me, so it took some time. Not that many games were included in here. I would guess majority of these 2TB are taken by AAA games. But there were some bangers in here too. Breath of the Wild, Tears of the Kingdom, Super Mario Odyssey, God of War 3. Emulation was solid, but this SSD wasn't specifically designed for Steam Deck. It was designed for any machine running Windows 8.1 and higher. So the performance will heavily depend on the specification of your machine. And you can also add your own ROMs and games to this SSD. Now to my final thoughts. To be honest, I was pleasantly surprised by this drive. I knew there are drives being sold loaded up with retro games, But I didn't know this can be done even with AAA games. I mean, I own a Steam account with a bunch of games that I still haven't even touched, so I don't really need to pirate games, but I can only imagine many people are still doing it even nowadays, in 2023. My friend being one of them. I've told him about this drive, and he was very intrigued, asking me a bunch of questions. I've asked him only one question. Why is he still doing it? Why doesn't he buy the games? His answer? Because the games cost as much in his poor country as in USA, where people do earn 5 times as much, but the games, of course, don't cost 5 times less. The prices are set, they are the same. Is it an excuse? You be the judge. The 2TB SSD drive cost about £110, link for it is down below. I wouldn't necessarily buy it for these handheld PCs, because it's not that convenient and it needs to be plugged into the dock. Either way, not a bad end-user experience. Thanks for watching. Thanks to members and Patreons for support. Peace out.
Sorry, Cal. Don't worry about it.
Good morning, guys. Who's ready for their hot, fresh cup of Molly Hart?